Everything just hurts. Everything's gotta go. Back to my channel. My name is Samir's Nodis. I don't really want to be too loud today. We're back in the iconic bathroom, and not iconic. We're back in the bathroom, and I'm just tired of these braids. It's time. Literally, I know that you guys really just probably saw me just post how I just got them, but like, I'm tired. Like, I'm so sick and tired of them. Like, I'm tired of them. I'm sick and tired of them. It's been over a month, and I'm just ready to do my hair. So first, like, the lady who should do my hair, she do like this. Hopefully I don't cut my hair, but like, yeah, to like keep the braids together, she did that. So basically this is what I'm going to do, and then I'm gonna take you guys with me Black Friday shopping / Cyber Monday. It's Cyber Monday, by the way. But yeah, and you know what the worst part is? I don't even have an idea of what my next hairstyle is going to be. I'm just going on vibes on what needs to be done now. I'm over this. You know, some people told me that y'all was cutting y'all hair when y'all got these damn faux locks. I was like, how the hell y'all end up doing that? But anyways, I'm really not gonna be talking much because I want to watch this YouTube video. My girl Kai Foster, I like watching her. I used to watch her a lot. I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm watching this video about how, you know, her boyfriend was like a narcissist. And you know what the crazy part is? I literally came across her on TikTok. I used to watch her a lot when I was younger. I'm saying it. If yeah, like she didn't do this, obviously we're gonna walk around like this. But yeah, I used to watch her, but you know, sometimes you get consumed into some other things and you just end up not watching YouTuber, which is like cool. But it's like, I thought that, you know, when I came across her on TikTok, I was like, oh my god, kind of and stuff. I was like, yeah, you have a boyfriend. Like, this was just months ago. And then this video popped up on my YouTube feed. Like, she was dating a narcissist. I was like, oh, I hope this isn't the current boyfriend. And then I saw the intro and it was her current boyfriend. Oh. Okay. Oof. I think that's the first set to be done. If I didn't have that, I would've been walking around like this. My hair should be good, right? Oh, when I was younger, I used to reuse braiding hair like a psychopath. Like, yeah, like I would take out the full braids, the whole length that it is, and braid them right back in my scalp. Like, oh, we've come so far. I'm scared about like the breakage, because like whenever you have a protective style, of course, like there's gonna be some breakage, but like I'm just worried because my hair is bleached and there's breakage. But yeah, and I have this ugly ass pimple on my chin. Like, what the fuck? If you're gonna let me down, let me down. Like, the person that made that mix, I hope you have clear skin and have a wonderful fucking morning. That is so fucking iconic.
Those moments to kind of, like, reel me back in. But, obviously, at the end of my relationship, I got pregnant. I had gained so much weight. I had terrible acne. I had no passion for YouTube. Like, he really depleted me of so much. So many resources. I did so much for him in terms of, like, money, in terms of, like, wanting to be there for him. Bought this nigga a phone. CDGs, flights, food, like, picked him up.
City girls down 1,000 points. Like,
but I just look back and I'm like, okay, he didn't seem as grateful for those things. He didn't do that much for me in return, and I wasn't asking for much, honestly, throughout the relationship. But like basic respect and consideration and like courtesy. I think a lot of guys get into relationships thinking that their girlfriend should meet them with unconditional love. And so every time that I had a problem, I was nagging or criticizing or, you know, complaining, and he would bring up the...
I'd be like a time lapse instead. Hi guys, so I'm just gonna be showing you guys like my Fenty card. I have like a gift card, and I'm sorry if you can like hear the lawnmower in the back. Like, we're just gonna have to power through this. So my friend got me a $50 gift card. I was like, I'm about to use that because I've never actually gotten Fenty, and I feel like I missed out on all the hype, but I can't like show you guys my information here, so this is where it's gonna end. But I'm gonna do a follow-up video on what I got from there. Next, I'm going over to Colourpop, and honestly I really wasted my time because like it's like between them and Juvia's Place, like my shade is just never in stock. It's like never in stock, and I had to get this candle, of course, because Hocus Pocus, and I don't care if Halloween is over. I've come up with this new mentality that spooky season is year-round. Even though Christmas is around the corner, I will be participating in that too, but spooky season, it's like a way of life. So I love their collection, so I'm like, okay, let's go into the Tim Burton collection, you know, the night before Christmas. Let's see what they got going on. They weren't really giving. I was kind of disappointed. I'm not really a lippy kind of girl because I barely have an upper lip, so I'm like, nah, this is, I'm good on this. So yeah, but it does look really nice, but it's just like, I just feel like it's just the same colors repackaged and with a different theme. It's like it's never really giving anymore. So yeah, I'm just scrolling through. Like I said, I'm not really a lip type of girl. It's always like the same lip combo, but the girls that have lips, go you. One day I'm gonna go get me some fillers. We can all be in the crew together. Yeah, so let's fast forward and see. Alrighty, so this part I was really excited for because, you know, Hocus Pocus from the movie, and I was really let down, really disappointed. Like, this is all it had to give. I was really, really disappointed. So yeah, so of course it wouldn't be like me. Like, I love scrolling on Colourpop and like seeing what they got going on, and skincare, you know, is really in now. So I'm like, I'm gonna go get some skincare. But the reason why I didn't check out is because they really didn't have my shade, and I'm gonna fast forward and show you guys now. See, now this is where it begins. Like, this concealer, $4.90, and I'm pretty sure my shade is like the dark N40 42. That's the one that I previously had, and that concealer, chef's kiss. It is so freaking good. Like, it is just so good, and like, it's like a good matte concealer. And plus these days I prefer a matte face over like dewy these days. I used to really prefer dewy, but I just look like a grease ball. And this is me like trying to figure out how can I like adjust and end up getting the concealer. But in the end, if I'm not, even if I put stuff in my cart, even if I put stuff in my cart, if I'm like, I'm mainly here for the concealer, guys. I'm not here for like the eyeshadow and stuff like that, because I have enough eyeshadow palettes. I haven't bought an eyeshadow palette in years because it's just like, it's tired, y'all, coming out the same thing. It's not giving. And here I am trying to, you know, go back and forth. Yeah, I'm zooming in because I'm real pressed that it's sold out. And my ass, I'm so hung up on this concealer because it is so good. I haven't had it in so long because I'm like, you know, I've been trying some other things. Like, it's really not clicking into my head that they don't have it. So I'm seeing if I can, like, you know, get a bit of a darker shade or anything. I'm trying to bargain, trying to see, but I just left it alone. So then I went to Ulta because, you know, Ulta Beauty.
And because I went in stores and they told me that they didn't have it, they only had the hydrating one. Well, I'm thinking, okay, maybe they have it there and in my shade. So here I am scrolling through, and like they really don't have the concealer. They only have the hydrating one. So this was really just a bust. And the same thing happened to Juvia's Place as well. When I was trying to find my foundation shade, Ulta was out, and the actual store as well. So I didn't end up purchasing anything from these people because they didn't have my shade, but maybe next time. Yeah, so I called it quits here, and oh, Good Molecules. I missed the sale, and so I didn't buy anything from the skincare. Next is Shein, of course. It wouldn't be, like, come on, guys. You know Shein's coming with the deals, even though, you know, it is starting to get a bit pricey these days, but it's whatever. First thing, I went into my shopping cart because I was watching this jacket. This jacket's really nice. It's $20, and there was one left the last time I checked it, and it was gone. I missed it. It's because I'm like, guys, I'm really, you know, really looking back and forth in my pockets. Like, I don't really like to splurge that much, but I want to do another haul. And this color, this puffer coat, this is really, really nice. So this might be the next purchase. You will definitely be seeing this in the haul. Don't know where the hell I'm going with it, but you'll definitely see me outside wearing this. And I live in Florida. It's 90 degrees, but you're gonna see me outside wearing this. Oh my goodness, guys. And then this dress, I was like, oh my gosh, this dress is so nice. But it doesn't really go into like the winter theme, because it's like I'm trying to do like a winter haul, so I'm really trying to get some good winter pieces going on. But guys, look at this. Oh, it looks so nice. But it's not winter time. I ended up adding it to my cart, but looking now, I'm probably gonna remove it because it just doesn't go with the whole winter thing. But it looks real cute, and I'll put it in my favorites instead.